Hello everyone, welcome back. I hope you all are fine. Before we start our next chapter, let's revise what we have learned so far. So, in which slice do you see a Sylvian fissure? If your answer was this slice, you are absolutely right. Let's have another one. On this film, in which slice do you see posterior fossa? If you answered any of these slices, you can consider yourself right. This was a recap of the previous video. Before starting this new chapter, I suggest you to watch the previous video for better understanding. You can see the link on the top right corner if you are new to this CT Brain series. Hello everyone, my name is Dr. Talha, and in this chapter we will learn about the cisterns and the ventricular system. As I told you in the previous video that when we scroll down towards the base of the brain, we see multiple deep CSF filled spaces which are known as cisterns. Some of them were discussed in the previous video. On a CT film, these slices are usually used to visualize the cisterns. This here, separating the frontal lobe from temporal lobe, is the Sylvian cistern. This cistern lying above the cella tertica is supracellar cistern, named according to its location. This W-shaped cistern lying posterior to the midbrain is the quadrigeminal cistern. And this one lying between the peduncles of the midbrain is named accordingly as interpeduncular cistern. Moving towards the base of the brain, this here is peripontine cistern as it lies around the pons. As we discussed this in previous video, that blood vessels lie safely in these cisterns, and sometimes these vessels can be visualized on a good quality CT scan. Basilar artery appears as a dot-like structure in peripontine cistern. MCA or middle cerebral artery can be seen in Sylvian cistern as white linear structure. Here is another image showing MCA. Previously, I have stated multiple times that the cisterns are filled with CSF. So, where does this CSF comes from? Before we start discussing the ventricular system on CT scan, let's revise the CSF flow pathway. In adults, approximately 400 to 600 ml CSF is produced by the choroid plexus located in the lateral ventricles mainly and fourth ventricle partly. CSF flows unidirectionally from lateral ventricles to the third ventricle via foramen of Monroe, passing through aqueduct of Sylvius to the fourth ventricle, and finally entering the subarachnoid spaces via two lateral foramina of Luschka and one median foramina called Magendie. After that, it is reabsorbed into venous system via arachnoid granulations. Here is a simplified flow chart for your better learning. Because of this CSF, which is a fluid, ventricles appear dark on a CT film. Here you can see both lateral ventricles joining with foramen of Monroe as we scroll down. Communicating with this slit-like structure, which is the third ventricle, third ventricle communicate with fourth ventricle via aqueduct of Sylvius. Here you can see the aqueduct of Sylvius. Here you can see the aqueduct of Sylvius joining the fourth ventricle that appears a bit triangular shaped. Now let's have a look on ventricular system on sagittal sections. This here is the lateral ventricle. This is the part of third ventricle. This narrow channel here is the aqueduct of Sylvius, which acts as a communication between the third ventricle and the triangular shaped fourth ventricle, which lies in the posterior fossa. Here is a simplified diagram. Hopefully, this video was helpful for you. In the next chapter, we will learn about brain parenchyma and deep brain nuclei. Stay tuned.